People are not one way. We are a reflection of the states we're living in. When you're in a frustrated state, an overwhelmed state, a tired state, your brain processes completely differently than if you're in a passionate state, whether you're feeling determined, whether you're feeling committed, whether you feel completely resolved. So learning to change the leader's state, learning how to change your own state. So, you know, people, one of the silliest questions I get asked is, you're not really that happy, are you? You have bad days, don't you? Of course they have, you know, bad times. But I don't have bad days anymore, and it's not BS. It's because I've trained myself like an athlete to go in these peak states so often that they're just natural for me. It's like building a muscle. So it's not like I'm so smart or I'm just so positive. It's just like, why would I waste my time stressing out? I have a 90-second rule. I'll stress for 90 seconds, but stress is not gonna solve it. Let me put myself back in a different state. And so the way I do that is I use my body, because I've done this with athletes for decades, with billionaire businessmen. I've been teaching for years that a radical change in your body instantly changes your biochemistry. 38 years I've taught it. 2 years ago at Harvard, they did a study, scientifically proven what I've been teaching all these decades, where they call it power postures.
Yeah, the Wonder Woman stance.
Yeah, standing right. Like Wonder Woman or Superman for 2 minutes.
Yep.
Or like you see a guy who's like this, pulled back like that for 2 minutes, literally increases your testosterone in your biochemistry within 2 minutes by 20%. It drops cortisol by 18%, which is the stress hormone, and increases your chance of taking a more risky behavior, which is what's required of a leader, by 33%, 2 minutes. Now that's just standing a certain way. I show people use their voice, their body, their movement, which is 10 times more dynamic than just a stiff stance. And when you change your state, your mental and emotional state, you change your performance. There are people that are born and upbred, maybe born with more certainty, like people are willing to take more risks. There certainly are people of that nature. But anyone can be a leader in something that they decide to become masterful in. You can be the leader of your own life. Everyone should lead their own life. You should be the leader of your family. And so I think everyone can be a leader, but there are different types and different styles of leadership. And I believe that leadership is a skill. It starts with having something that you're committed to that's larger than yourself, a vision that's bigger than yourself. If there's a large enough vision, if you have enough passion for that vision, then you're gonna have enough drive to actually start to execute. And then leadership is the capacity to discipline your disappointment, because you're gonna have to go through failures, and instead of making failures, you have to learn from those. And then it comes down to the skill of influence once again. And so anyone can learn, anyone can develop a vision, anyone can uncover their passion, anyone can learn to influence. That's a skill that can be learned. So yes, leadership can be taught and leadership can be learned. Can everyone be a leader? The answer is yes, because there's so many different things to lead in, and it's not a situation like you have to follow me for you to lead. I just have to know what it is I truly stand for. So I always say there are two things that influence everyone. If you want to be a leader, you have to know how to change other people's states. A person is in a no state, a person's in an angry state, a person's in a frustrated state. You have to be able to influence their state, because if you change their state, you're going to change the result they get. But the second thing you have to understand is, what are people's blueprints? Blueprint's my shorthand for, what are the values? What do they believe? What do they fear? I always say to people that life is found in the dance between what you desire most and what you fear most. If I want to lead you and support you, I got to know your goals, your desires. I got to know what you're scared about, what you're fearful about, what stresses you out. And if I understand that, I can communicate in a way that'll inspire you to maximize, not only when I'm here, that's management. Leadership is, I'm gone, and you've raised your own standard, and you're going to continue to perform at a higher level. Well, how should they think about failure? Yeah. They've got to look at it as learning. I mean, anyone who is incredibly successful has failed more than other people. You just don't see it because they got back up so fast and they learned from it, right? That's really how it is. The fastest way to avoid failure is not to learn by your own experience, but to learn by other people's experiences, right? The way I believe in compressing decades into days, and the way you do that is modeling, once again. Finding someone who is the most successful in the world, it's taken them 20, 30 years, and digging in and figuring out what is the core essence of what's made them successful. What are the failures they had, what they learned from them, so you can avoid them. So, but the other part is, you also have to know that success is buried on the other side of failure. It's buried on the other side of frustration. It's buried on the other side of conflict. And so you have to see this as part of the natural evolution. I really think we're all afraid to fail, but it's the only way to learn sometimes. I mean, when people succeed, they tend to party. When you fail, you tend to ponder. And then the pondering is when you usually get the growth, the insight, the strategy that'll change your business, that'll change your personal life, that'll change your finances. And so I think, I don't vote for failure for anybody, but to think you're not gonna experience it is absurd. The way to not experience it is to turn into the learning. The person that can go through failure like butter and it doesn't stop them, they just change their approach, change their, I mean, how long will you give your average child to learn how to walk? You know, before you shut them off and said, you're not a walker. People go, what are you crazy? My kids are gonna keep trying until he or she, you know, is a walker. Well, that's why almost everybody walks.
Right.
But singing, how many people sing? Small amount. If someone says, what's that noise you're making? Stop that, you're not a singer. Well, once you decide that, you stop trying. Failure is only when you permanently give up. If you learn anything and you apply what you've learned, failure is a stepping stone.